of the other in a bag with the rerun shows and the cocaine knows ya. The daytime crap of the folk singers club. He hung himself with a guitar string, a slab of turkey neck, and it's hanging from a pigeon wing. But get right if you can't relate. Trade the cash for the beat, for the body, for the hate. And my time is a piece of wax falling on a termite who's choking on the splinters. So
this is the world of business. Exciting, dynamic, turbulent, dangerous. In the high-tech world of today, the business landscape is terra incognita, unknown territory, much like the American wilderness explored by Lewis and Clark. To master today's dangerous business landscape, we need to look back to the words of the wisest men in history. That is why we have such business masterpieces as Lincoln on Leadership and Bugsy Siegel, Las Vegas Entrepreneur. Now we have a new source of inspiration, Lewis and Clark. They succeeded in their historic journey. They explored and mapped the unknown because they were masterful planners, leaders, and businessmen. In fact, their story is still the basis for an industry today. The Lewis and Clark journey has spawned many useful consumer products. Lewis and Clark's wisdom can help today's business person kill the grizzly bears of undercapitalization, navigate the icy waters of foreign markets, and destroy the savage, bloodthirsty competitors with the smallpox virus of sound marketing strategy. I am Dr. William Clueless, management scholar and Lewis and Clark expert, author of The Essence of Strategic Decision-Making and Unreliable Courage, The True Story of Lewis and Clark. I bring you a professional development video unlike any you have ever seen. You are about to experience the awe and majesty of Lewis and Clark's seven secrets of management success. We will not be filming in lecture halls or corporate boardrooms. This is our lecture hall. This is our boardroom. Come with me and I'll be your guide through the minds of the greatest leaders who ever lived, Lewis and Clark. Great leadership begins with a grand business vision. True leaders have such lofty goals that ordinary people often think they're crazy. People told Lewis and Clark they were crazy. Their vision was to explore and map this vast new continent and open it for trade and settlement. How can you top that as a grand vision? Well, as a leader, it's your job to figure that out. What's your grand vision? Remember, the bolder and the crazier your vision, the better. For example, a guy named Ken Lay once dreamed of turning a mediocre energy company into the world's premier energy trading firm. The company, Enron. Once you have your grand vision, do whatever is necessary to fund it. I mean whatever is necessary. Don't let the auditors or bean counters starve your vision of the cash it needs. Let me give you an example from Lewis and Clark. You know, they weren't the first to cross the continent to the Pacific Ocean. The first was Alexander Mackenzie, who did it in 1792. He did it cheaply and efficiently. 12 men in 17 days for the whole trip. That's a typical Canadian project. Not very grand. Not really the American way. Lewis and Clark took over 30 men, plus a woman and a baby, and took 2.5 years to make their trip. Now that is a grand American adventure. You think it was cheap? Absolutely not. Where did they get the money for it? Congress approved $2,500 for the expedition, more than Mackenzie spent. But Lewis and Clark ended up spending $30,000. Jefferson just didn't tell Congress about it. Now, some children in the audience might ask, isn't that stealing? Absolutely not. It's simply taking money from people who said you couldn't have it. Great leaders like Bernie Ebers of WorldCom weren't really stealing when he spent his shareholders' money on a megalomaniacal acquisition spree. Ebers was merely feeding his grand vision. How can modern executives get away with this? Two simple words. Creative accounting.